Hi, I'm Dennis Flank, and this is a tutorial to the Shine action for Adobe Photoshop. The link to the action you can find in the description. In this tutorial, we will do all the preparations before using the action. Then we will run the action and do the steps to improve our result. I hope this video would be interesting and helpful for you, and you will get many nice results using my action. Let's start. At first, make sure that you are using the compatible version of Adobe Photoshop. This action was tested with Photoshop versions from CS6 up to the actual version for now CC 2021, so you need one of these versions to make the action work fine. It may work with the newer versions that will release after this video published, but sometimes Adobe makes things that break the action. The action is multilingual, that means that you wouldn't get the error messages if your Photoshop has the different language settings. Let's open our image. To do this, we have to go to the menu File, Open, and select the image to process. The Shine action works with the images that have at least 1000 pixels by the smallest side and not more than 5000 pixels by the biggest side. You can check the image size at menu Image, Image Size. Your image must have a color depth of 8 bits per channel and RGB color mode. You can check this information at menu Image, Mode. Check the Photoshop options. Choose the brush tool on the Tools panel or press the B button and select the opacity and flow settings to 100%. Check your Layers panel options. Press the button at the top right corner of the Layers panel and find the Panel Options menu. Activate the Use Defaults Masks on Fill Layers checkbox. Double-click on the Quick Mask Mode button at the Tools panel will open the Quick Mask options and enters you to the Quick Mask mode. Check that the Masked Areas option is selected. Press the OK button and press Q button to exit the Quick Mask mode. Now we need to open the Actions panel and load the action files. If the action panel is hidden, go to the menu Window and show the actions panel. Then go to the menu File Open, select the Shine ATN and Shine Brushes ABR files and press OK. That will load these files to the Photoshop and you will see the new action appeared at the actions panel. You can find the short instructions inside the action. To read it, you need to select the instructions action and press the play button. Let's prepare our image. The action needs the additional layer where we will select the edit area. Press the Create a new layer button at the bottom of the layers panel. Then double click on the layer's name and change it to the brush. All the letters have to be lowercase. To select the area, you can use the different tools such as Brush Tool, B button, Pen Tool, P button, any of Quick Selection Tools, W button, all depending on your skills and the accuracy of the desired result. The Shine action doesn't need the precise selection, so I'm using the easiest way, Brush Tool. After we selected the edit area, we can play the action. Choose the action depending on the average size of your image and Photoshop version and press play button. The final result is layered and available for edit. That is what you can do with the basic options. Change the shadow power by hiding or showing the shadow layers inside the object dots group. By default, only one shadow layer is shown, and the more layers you show, the darker result would be. The layer named Blurred Dots to Double inside the Object Dots group is amplifying the dots. So if they are too bright, you can change the fill or opacity settings of this layer. The fill and opacity settings are the main for the most layers of the final result. If you see that some part of the effect is too bright, you can decrease the brightness with these options. If you want to change the dots or background color, you have to open the color options group and double-click on the icon of the dots color or space color layers. The color panel will appear and then you can change it. Inside the light effect group, you can find the three color layers. Showing or hiding these layers and changing the fill or opacity settings will give you the interesting color effects. For advanced editing, you can use the pixel mask to control the different areas of the layers. The darker the area on the pixel mask, the more transparent that area will be on the layer. This is like the eraser tool, but you always can restore the erased area. If you want to hide some areas of the layer or group, select the layer or group. Create the pixel mask with the button on the bottom of the layers panel. Select the brush tool and choose the brush you will paint with. Changing the opacity and flow settings on the top panel will control the brush power. Paint on the pixel mask with the black color to hide the area and with the white color to show the area. You can use this function to remove unnecessary dots, clear the bokeh effect, to add shadows or else. Finally, this is our result that we got from the simple image. This is my first voice video and it was hard enough for me. The English isn't my native language, so sorry for the mistakes. Feel free to say your mind about it, or about the Shine action, or just say hi to me at the comments. I will try to answer you as soon as possible. I will be very grateful for your subscription and your feedback. Thank you for watching and I'll be glad to see you on my channel again.